Now that we have our spreadsheets created and configured, let's create our app and connect to it. In order to do that, let's first close the spreadsheet. Sometimes Power Apps doesn't behave very well when the spreadsheet is open and we are using the app, so let's close if you are not doing anything inside it. We see that here inside our course files folder, and the name of the file is app data file. Now let's go back to Power Apps and click on the apps, and let's create the app here on new app. We are going to choose canvas as we already saw in the previous classes. And here we are going to use the phone format because it's going to be used mainly by smartphones. Okay, the name, I'm going to give the name Power Contacts. Okay, that's going to be the name of my app. You can choose your name or you can just put the same. Now let's click on create, and we are going to see that's going to give us a blank canvas in a phone format. Here is where we are going to start developing our app. But before developing, let's connect to the data source, that's in this case is the spreadsheet we just created in the previous class. In order to connect, let's go here in this pane and click on data. Here we have the add data button. And once we click, we can start searching for the connectors, and let's type, in this case, OneDrive. Maybe it needs to be all together. Yes, OneDrive. Here we have OneDrive and OneDrive for Business. In this case, in my case, is OneDrive for Business because I'm using a OneDrive for Business account. If you create it in a personal account, you can just use the first one to connect. If you put the Excel file inside a SharePoint folder, you are going to search by SharePoint and then click here on SharePoint. Right, let's search for the OneDrive for my case. Click here, and you need to create a connection if you don't have one. A connection is something you're going to create just to be able to connect to these different data sources. In my case, I already have one. But if I were to create a new one, I would just click here on add a connection and click on connect. It would create a new one. I'm going to use the one I already have, so I don't need to create a new one. So let's search for OneDrive again, but you can create yours. I'll pick this one, and now it will ask me to choose the Excel file. I will need to navigate through the folders to find my file. And I know here that's the course files folder. And inside here, we have the file, the app data file. Once I click, it will show the table that's inside the file that's called TB Contacts. That's why we transformed it in a table and we gave this name. Imagine we have 10 tables, then it will be very difficult to find the correct one if the names are table 1, table 2, table 3, and so on. Right now, let's select the TB Contacts and click on connect. Once it connects, it will show here, inside this data parts, the table that's connected here. If we had more and different data sources, we would see all the connections here. How can I see this data inside Power Apps? Let's do a quick approach here just to visualize the data that's inside the spreadsheet here by adding a table. So I'm going to go here to Insert and then find for table. So I'm going to type table here. It's inside the layout part, and it's here, data table. It's not very used. There is a gallery that shows also data, but right now, just for us to see the data, let's use it. It's quick to connect, so let's use this one right now. Here, it's inserted a table that's empty because we didn't tell the table what's the data source. With the table selected, I'm going to choose the data source that's TB Contacts. Now it's connected, but it doesn't show any data yet. In order to show, we need to tell the table what are the columns that we want to show here. To do that, we have the fields property here in the sides. Let's click on edit fields, and then we can add fields to the table. I'm going to click here on add field and select all the fields I want to show. In this case, I'm going to select all of them. Pay attention that the order that you select is the order that will appear in the table. So, but we can change later. but let's select the in the correct order. Name, phone, department, email, and comments. That's the order I want to show here. I'm going to click on Ads. It will add these fields to the table. I can close this pop-up here, and we see the values right here inside the table, inside the Canvas app. I can play the app and see all the register here. If I can add a new register to the Excel file, and it will reflect here. Let's do this test. So I'm going to go back to the OneDrive, open the file, and just add a new register here to the end. Let's say John. Just put some number here, some things for the some information for the email, john@email.com, department, IT, moments, just John. Okay, we just added a new register. Let's close the file and go back to Power Apps. In order for it to reflect here and show, or you need to open the app again, save and open the app again, or you can just go to the data source, click on this ellipsis, and then click on refresh to reload the data. Once it finished refreshing, Jones should appear here. Sometimes it takes a couple seconds or minutes because Excel is a little slower and we just closed the Excel file. Let's just try again, refreshing. After a couple of tries, it will appear. It's just here, John. We see that it's reflecting all the data that's inside the spreadsheets. Okay, now let's see how to save this app. It's highly recommended to save once you create, so it starts saving automatically after that. I have already created an app and didn't save, and after a long time, I closed and forgot to save for the first time and lost all the work I have done before. So now I learned that once I create, I already save. Okay, I just saved the app, and now for us to be able to play and share with others, we need to publish the app. That's here in the last button. We already saw in the introduction. So I published and click here and publish this version. And now the app's published and able to be played and shared. Let's go to make.powerapps.com and see if we can find our Power Contacts app in there. So I'm going to go to make.powerapps.com and let's see, let's go to apps. Here is Power Contacts. I'll click here and I will select the app and click on play. Once I play the app, we should see the data table here showing in the screen. See, here's the table and it's loading the data from the Excel file and showing here right now. Okay, now we are ready to start building our app since we have already the data source and the connection established. I see you in the next class where you're going to start creating elements in the screens. See you, bye bye.